This is the last kingdom where you all fall in. Matthew generally falls into Kingdom Animalia, which is our last kingdom for under taxonomy. We know that organisms here are eukaryotic. I've said that times without number. They are divided into two broad groups. You have the invertebrates and the vertebrates. In classifying organisms, we can easily say that their body division, their body design, their body cavity, and their body symmetry can be used to classify organisms. Their body design, all organisms, or let me say most animals, have an entry path called the mouth, and an exit called the what? The anus. Now, anus is the part where undigested food particles get outside of the body. If they don't, if it doesn't get out of the body, it will be a disturbance to the body. The mouth is a, we use the mouth for mechanical digestion, which is also called chewing. You can also use the mouth for, we call it ingestion, either mechanical digestion or ingestion. They mean the same thing. Ingestion is just the taking in of food. All animals do that. Now, body cavity. Body cavity, primitive organisms, those are organisms. Primitive organisms are divided into two body cavities. That's your ectoderm and your endoderm. But more advanced organisms are divided into three, which is your endoderm, mesoderm, and ectoderm. I've said that. When we say body cavity, we are talking about the three forms of advanced body cavity, the acoelomates, the pseudoelomates, and the coelomates. Acoelomates are called no body cavity. Pseudoelomates, we call them false body cavity, like your amoeba. And the coelomates, like man, we have a true body cavity. Body symmetry is just how the line of symmetry found in living organisms, living animals. We have the asymmetrical ones, no symmetry, no line of symmetry. And then you have the radially symmetrical ones, and then you have the bilaterally symmetrical ones. For the forms of bilateral symmetry, we'll be treating that in our practical class. Where, when you hear dorsal, when you hear ventral, what does it mean? If we say we want a dorsal view of something, what does it mean? If we have a, if we need a ventral view of something, what does it mean? We'll be explaining that in our practical class. Now quickly, like I said earlier on, animals are divided into invertebrates and vertebrates. Invertebrates are animals without backbone. Vertebrates are animals with backbone. Now invertebrates are 8 in number. You have the porifera, the coelenterata, the annelids, the mollusca, platyhelminths, nematoda, arthropods, echinodermata, and then you have your coelenterata. This is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now let's start off with the poriferans. I'm not going to give you stories about them. You read them all. Poriferans, the only examples you need to know, which of these is a poriferan? Once you see sponges there, you know that is your answer. Which of these is a coelenterata? Once you see hydra, coral polyps, jellyfish, they are all coelenterates. If I say annelids, annelids, examples are your earthworms and your leeches. Examples are your earthworms and your leeches. What about mollusca? You have your snails, your periwinkles, your squids, your mussels, your bivalves, etc. Nematodes, they are just your round worms. When we say nematodes, you have your hookworm, your thread worms, your filaria worm, ascaris, they are also called nematodes. Now, platyhelminths, these are your flatworms, your tapeworm, planaria, fasciolus, etc. Now, but this is where I love talking about, under invertebrates. You see this group, this class Arthropoda, is subdivided into four. You have your insecta,
you have your prostitutions, you have your Maria Buddha, you have your arachnida. Let's start off with insects. If I ask you that, how many of you have seen an insect before? Definitely you will say you have. But oftentimes people, if I see a spider up there and I say, kill that insect, the ideal thing you should tell me is that that's not an insect. That's a what? An arachnid. Insects are of two types. We have insects based on how they shed off their body, their exoskeleton. So we can classify them into two. We have those that undergo complete metamorphosis and those that undergo incomplete metamorphosis. When you say complete metamorphosis, complete metamorphosis means from the egg to the larva, from the larva to the pupa, from the pupa to the imago, imago or adult. So these ones undergo complete metamorphosis. The normal insects you see around, they are often complete metamorphosed insects. Examples of complete metamorphosed insects, you have mosquito, you have housefly, you have butterfly, you have ants. And these are just examples of complete metamorphosed insects. Please note, the fact that they have larva should tell you that their larva have specific names. If I ask you what is the larva of housefly, the larva of housefly is called maggot. Before you see housefly in your house, you would have seen lots of maggots. And then when they continue to metamorphose and develop, they eventually become housefly. Now the larva of butterfly is your caterpillar. And the larva for mosquito is your wriggler. These questions come out a lot in why. You know that in some of your SATI GCSE exams. So the larva of mosquito is wriggler, the larva of housefly is maggot, the larva of butterfly is caterpillar, the larva of ant and so many others is your grub. Please note that. Now, I often said that there are another set of insects, they undergo incomplete metamorphosis. Now that means from the egg, they go to the larva and straight to the world imago. They don't have a pupa stage. They don't have a resting stage. Now examples of organisms that undergo incomplete metamorphosis, you have your termites, you have your praying mantis, you have your cockroach, you have your locusts, you have your dragonfly, and then you have your grasshopper, amongst others. So these are examples of insects that undergo incomplete metamorphosis. These are examples. Now crustaceans, all of you eat crustaceans, like your prawns, your crabs, your crayfish. These are examples of crustaceans. The myriapodes. Oftentimes people mistake myriapodes for nematodes or platyhelminths. They say, which of these is not a flat worm? Which of these is not a round worm? Once you see centipede and millipede there, they are arthropods. What type of arthropods are they? They are called myriapods or myriapoda. And then the last one, you have your arachnids. The arachnids are, examples of the arachnids are your scorpions and your spider. So we'll go straight to vertebrates, where we all belong.